Hey guys, this is Alfredo from isledesign.org, and today I'm going to teach you how to make a pretty cool looking water ripples texture using Photoshop. So I'm going to go down to Photoshop, I'm going to click it to open it. I'm using version CS5, but it should work with pretty much any contemporary version of Photoshop. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to File, and I'm going to create a new document. You can also hit Command-N or Control-N if you're using a PC. I'm using a Mac right now. And yeah, I believe 700 by 700 is a good size for this. So I'm going to go ahead and click OK. Now before I do anything else, what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit the D key on my keyboard. And what that does is it reverts my foreground and background colors back to black and white. Okay, and I'm also going to go up here to the Arrange Documents button. I'm going to click on that, and I'm going to choose to consolidate all. Just that way our entire canvas is in focus here. Okay, so the first step we're going to do is we're going to go down here to the Layers panel, and I'm going to choose to create a new layer with this button right here. So there it is, and I'm going to rename it Ripples. Okay, now the next step, we're going to go up here to Filter, and we're going to go all the way down to Render, and we're going to choose Clouds. Okay, so here's our cloud render. And just a little tidbit, every time you do the cloud filter, you can see if I do it again and again and again, it's different every time you do it. So just for the sake of this tutorial, make sure you have one that has some good variation. Like there's a lot of whites here, a lot of blacks here, so the more variation, the better. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go back up to filter. And this time I'm going to choose pixelate and crystallize. Okay, and as you can see, the crystallized filter makes this makes the image look kind of like a stained glass window. And you can play with the controller. You can make the cell size bigger or smaller. I'm going to go with 15. I think 15 is a good size for now. I'm going to click OK. And as you can see, our cloud texture is now crystallized. So now what we got to do is we got to go up to Filter yet again. And we're going to go down to Stylize this time. And now we're going to choose Find Edges. And as you can see, it did just that. It found all the edges of the cells in our crystallized cloud texture, and it highlighted them. Now the next thing we have to do is we have to invert all of these colors. So I'm going to go up here to Image, Adjustments, and I'm going to choose Invert. Or if you're a keyboard savvy like I am, you can also do Command-I or Control-I. It'll do the same thing. So all right, so now all the colors are inverted, and we have a whole bunch of squiggly lines. And now, to finally get the basic foundation of our ripple texture, we're going to go up to Filter yet again. And now we're going to go to Distort, and we're going to choose Ocean Ripple. Okay, and here's a preview of what the filter is going to make our texture look like. And this is basically the gist of it right here. You can see on the right over here, you have these little controllers. You can adjust the size. Obviously, the higher the number, the bigger the ripples. I think 10 is pretty satisfactory for now, though. Magnitude is basically the intensity of the effect. You can see if I bring the magnitude down to zero, I have no ripples. And as I go up and up and up, I'm creating more and more. Though 13's a bit too much. I think I'm going to go with 6. I think 6 is pretty good. I'm going to click OK. Alright, now you're probably wondering, okay, I got the white ripples, but I have all this black in the background, so how do I get rid of all the black and leave myself with just the white? Well, in order to do that, we use what's called a blending mode for our layer. So what I'm going to do first, just to show you how this works, I'm going to make the ripples layer invisible by clicking this eyeball right here. And I'm going to select my background layer, and I'm going to fill it with a color. So I'm just going to go over to my gradient tool. You can also hit G. And since we're doing ocean ripples, I'm going to go with a good blue. So I'm going to click and drag, create my gradient. There we go. And now I'm going to click the eyeball icon again on the ripples layer and turn it back on. And now I'm going to go down to my layers panel and I'm going to select the ripples layer. And now you see this drop box right here? This is all the blending modes that you can set for the layer. And I'm going to choose screen because what screen does is it takes all the light parts of the layer and basically it cancels out all the dark parts. So when a layer is set to screen, only the light parts show up, just like that. So this is a pretty neat effect we have here, but what if you really want to make those ripples pop? They seem kind of flat and static right now, don't they? So in order to make them pop, what we're going to do is we have to duplicate the ripples layer. And you can do that one of two ways. You can either right-click and choose Duplicate Layer, or if you're of the impatient sort like I am, you can click and drag the layer down to the New Layers button, and it'll automatically make you a new layer. And I'm going to rename the Ripples copy to Ripples Glow. Okay. And I'm going to turn off screen just for now, just so you can see what this next effect actually does. I'm going to choose normal again, and you can see all the black parts are back. What I'm going to do with my Ripples Glow layer selected is I'm going to go to Filter, and this time I'm going to go to Blur, and Gaussian Blur, or Gaussian Blur. Not really sure how you're supposed to say it. And the radius, I would go with 3. Hit OK. And you can see our Ripples Glow is now blurred out. Next thing we're going to do is go up to Image, Adjustments, and Color Balance. The hotkey for this one is Command-B. And you can see here we have a whole bunch of controllers. Color Balance basically just filters a whole bunch of color into the image. So you can see you have all these little trackers right here. So if I click on this one and I go all the way out to Cyan, you can see that my ripples start to get more cyan in color. And you can do the same with any colors here. I'm pretty satisfied with the cyan though, so I'm going to click OK. And now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to reset Ripples Glow back to screen. And that, again, that'll make only the light part show through. And now you can see, it looks as if the ripples are glowing and glistening, and it just looks a lot more natural. So, that's basically the gist of the effect. You can apply this to anything, too. You can apply this to drawings, if you use Photoshop as a painting tool, just like I do. You can even apply it to photographs if you want. I'll give you a quick example. I'm going to open up a painting that I did. This is a background that I painted for a computer game that I'm actually creating right now called Unconscious Fairy Tale. It's a role-playing game. And you can see here I have a nice little beach scene, but I don't know, that water looks a little too flat. So I'm going to go to the ripples I just made. I'm going to select them. And I'm going to drag them over and drop them right into my image. And now obviously I have to fit them to the water, so I'm going to hit Command-T to bring up the transforming bounding box. And I'm going to scale them down. Little tidbit, if you hold down the Option key while you transform, it'll transform both sides instead of just one. You can see if I don't hold Option, I'm only transforming one side, and by holding Option, I'm transforming both. So that's a good size. I'm going to drag it up to the water, drag it out. And that's a bit more convincing for water, wouldn't you say? Now obviously I would go back and I would erase some areas, make some areas brighter, you know, boost the contrast a little bit, but this is just an example. So you can see, it makes the water a lot more convincing looking. This is without the ripples texture, this is with, without, and with. And that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any questions, please ask me and I'll be happy to answer them once I get the chance. This is Alfredo from isledesign.org, signing out.